Mark Simpson has had a limited game time this year. When he's been on, I thought he looked to me a bit tentative, but particularly in the first half, the battles we had with Lurie and Tony Bott were pretty impressive. Is that the kind of performance you can build on?
I think so. I think Jack done a lot of good things today. And I think we did as a group. I think we had one moment where Liam Kelly's gone long and direct in the first half, which led to Tony Watt being in on goal, so we'll have to look at that one. I thought we had two bad moments, one in the first half, one in the second. Obviously, the second one leads to the goal, which we spoke to the group about. But today, for me, that was a 3-4-0 game. If we showed more quality in the final third, I don't think it was anything really to do with how we defended. For me, we got to the final third on so many occasions. Some of our play in terms of our preparation and our build was outstanding today, but we never rewarded ourselves and we never took control of the game and the points at 1-0. And when you do that, if you don't go and take your chances and kill teams off, you leave yourself vulnerable at the back, and we did today.
Yeah, Stephen, just how frustrating is that? You've spoken in recent weeks about us maybe not starting games quite as well as we could have. Today, Rangers seemed to come out of the trap so quickly, and that level of performance seemed to drop off a bit in the second half. How frustrating is that?
It's frustrating because we should be sitting here now saying we're 3 points clear, and we should be talking about people getting assists and goals and rewarding ourselves, because we started the game ever so well. You know, when teams come and they're really disciplined and they're organised, it's about forcing that breakthrough, and we got that through fashion, and we kept the heat on. But I've seen it so many times, you've got to go and keep the standards as high as you can to go and get the second goal and the third goal, otherwise you leave yourself open for one issue or defending one situation not well, which we did. You know, the long ball into Van Veen, he chests it down, he's allowed to come inside. You can't allow that, and you leave yourself vulnerable for 2 points getting stole off you. It'll feel like a win to Motherwell because they've come here for something, but for us it'll feel more like a defeat because we've took the lead and we've got to the final third on so many occasions, but we haven't rewarded ourselves for our good play.
Stephen, is it a case of you brought in three players today in the first half, you were absolutely terrific in terms of movement up front, but was it just a case of maybe then needing that sharpness in front of the goal to come with more regular game time?
Well, look, they're all looking really sharp in training, but you've got to go and deliver on the big stage. We've been patient with fashion. You know, we had a bit of a stop start pre-season, but he's ready now, he's fit, he's looking likely. Kemar Roof came in, obviously fresh tonight. He had a fantastic chance on 47 minutes, so we're getting there. We're creating the opportunities. I think at half time we said to them we created 14 chances, 6 on target. You've got to get more than one goal on the back of that. Otherwise, you're going to leave yourself frustrated come the end of the game, and that's how it feels, because we should be sitting 3 points clear at the top of the table. We still look top. We're still top, but it's still frustrating because we should be top by more.
The substitutions came a bit later on today in the game. Was that with the intent of letting the starting 11 go
into themselves? No, it came on the back that we were still getting down the sides of the box, we were still getting it to crossing positions, we were still finding our wide triangles to be creative, we were still putting crosses into the good areas. It was about someone stepping forward and going, this game's ours, these points are ours, but unfortunately no one could do that for us today. So the subs, you know, we would have liked more attacking options on the bench today. Obviously Ryan's injured and we've got a few other issues as well, but we didn't feel like we were performing bad to make a substitution, so that's why we decided to go a bit later with it.
In previous seasons sometimes the team were getting pushed out wide a little bit, but today, again particularly in the first half, there was a lot of players taking on responsibilities to drive through the defence.
Yeah.
And it was quite often it was just that last pass that was letting them down.
Exactly, and well done on your observation, because I think a lot of teams are going to set up to block the middle of the pitch and force us out wide. Today what I thought Motherwell done well is they stopped our crossing really well. They were blocking Tav's crosses and they were blocking Bonner's crosses, so we've had to improve and evolve by passing and running, by being more spiteful, passing inside the pitch, passing and running, and trying to be more aggressive in our team selection. You know, we had obviously three really attacking players in Scott, Fashion and Kamar. We put Joe Aribo, who's going to join that, so we tried to be as aggressive as we can. And you look at this game and it'll look like Motherwell's, a lot of positives for Motherwell, but we got there today. we got down the side of the box, we got into the 6-yard box, we Kamaz had a tap in to go and make it 2-0. That's where the frustration comes, that we haven't gone and rewarded ourselves for all our good play, and people should be talking about 3 or 4 goals today. Unfortunately, we've only got one.
Yeah, just wanted to touch on what you were just saying there about the front three, Stephen. Certainly looked a lot more interchangeable in that final third. Maybe, you know, sometimes when we start with Alfredo, he's obviously going to be right through the middle. The front three that start today, does that give you more options going forward in the season?
Yeah, definitely. I think Scott Wright and Fashion today brought speed. There was a lot of interchange, and I thought some of Kamar's link-up play was good. It's about me finding the right balance for the right challenge. Obviously, we need Ryan back as soon as possible and back in top form. And we need to get Morelos in top form, because if you look at the first, 8-9 games, we haven't got a leading goal scorer that's jumping out, or a leading assister who's jumping out. And that's what we're going to need moving forward. So I'm going to challenge all the boys in the final third like I do, and hopefully we can become a bit more of a killer team, because we're getting there on too many occasions and not rewarding ourselves. That's a bit of a concern sitting here right now.
Stephen, even allowing for a bit of frustration today, you mentioned there that you think that you saw a lot of good stuff and it's coming. It's like a sense of, look, I know how good this team is and I know it's going to deliver, and we're sitting in a pretty good position for when people outside the club are saying that we haven't been playing well.
Look, listen, we're in a good position, but we should be in a better position, and it's my job to drive the standards here, and we'll never settle for accepting a draw at home to anyone. You know, I'm going to challenge the boys like I always do. Football's about details at the top level. Defensively, we got one or two details wrong today. One from a goalkeeper, just a straightforward punt up the field, which we nearly got punished for. And the second one, we got punished for poor defending for the goal. But we might have got away with that if our final third play was a lot better today. People need to stand up and score goals for this football club. That's what will get us success at the end of the day. So it's my job to challenge them, and I will.
Stephen, our first look at Mino Pequena today. I thought he had a couple of nice touches, a couple of opportunities. How has he been settling?
Well, he's looking more and more ready now. When he come in, we knew he hadn't had a pre-season. He was training alone at Huddersfield. He's got major talent. You can see some of the positions he picked up today and some of the little combinations he's looking for. Okay, he might be looking at me thinking I want a little bit more game time, which is good. That's a good place to be in, but there's going to be an opportunity for him very soon, because he's looking more ready now than when he come. He's fitter, he's more robust, and he knows a little bit more about our style, how we want to play now. So I think more opportunities for him at Innamans.
Stephen,